SEWERAGE SYSTEMS GHANA LIMITED, a liquid waste management company, was incorporated into force in 2012. SSGL, as it is popularly called, is a member of the Jospon group of companies.
And what we are doing now is we have three plants we are managing. We have the Mudo wastewater treatment plant, and the Lavender Hill fecal treatment plant, and then another fecal treatment plant at Kotoku. Our main mission is to serve the good people of Ghana, starting with the Accra metropolis, with a good system of liquid waste disposal and management.
The Lavender Hill Waste Treatment Plant is a multi-system processing plant. It takes waste through a mechanical, chemical and biological drill to end products like sludge for organic compost manure, biogas and clear water. The plant has various sections that runs the offloaded waste, that is the offloading bay, the screening section, the dewatering section, the biogas generation section, the electricity generation section, and the water treatment section.
As of today, the plant operates with an average of 180 to 200 trucks per day. We have a total design capacity of about 240, 250 trucks per day, but the maximum capacity goes up to 300 trucks per day.
Eight septic tanks can be accommodated at a go at the offloading bay, and it takes approximately 10 minutes to offload waste from each truck. The next phase is the grade integrated machine, where other particles like sand and its like are screened and separated from the water. The liquid waste moves to the dewatering section from the storage and inner buffer tanks.
We are to produce biogas of quantity 7,000 cubic meters per day as per the design. And we are supposed to purify it to generate electricity of 7.5 megawatts per day. The electricity that will be generated will be used to power our plant, and also when it's in excess, we send some to the nearby communities for them to use.
The department of this treatment plant responsible for data is made up of three major components, that is laboratory, quality control, and research. The process regime employed in the treatment of fecal matter needs vital data to inform the efficiency of accurate results furnished from the physiochemical laboratory.
Basically, there are nine fundamental analysis that we are mandated by law, EPA. You have to make sure we meet those ones. There are nine. We have the BOD, we have the COD, we have the color, we have conductivity, we have oil and grease, we have pH, TDS, and turbidity. These are the fundamental ones.
Everything passes through underground. At the offloading bay, we are able to reduce pollution since it's not open down, it's through pipes. We have screens, we have primary screens, secondary and tertiary, where we remove the pads, condom, t-shirt, sponge, slippers, shoes, waste and all those things.
There are about 20 other analyses conducted to derive biochemical informations that would help improve on the entire process of waste treatment. The physiochemical laboratory's findings aid quality control and research, making this department the heartbeat of the treatment plant as a whole.
The multi-million dollars that have been invested, you need data to form other works that you may implement somewhere. And this is the section that have the data. For instance, all the COD-BOD ratios that will inform whether the influenza that is coming will be treatable or not is going to come from here. It's one of the examples, and all the fundamental analysis that we do. This is the lab, and all the activities that we do, we make sure we document them.
The plant now operates 24 hours. We start receiving trucks every day as early as 4 a.m. in the morning and as late as 11 or 12 midnight. We have two shifts of operators. The number of staff is increasing dramatically. We have close to 100 employees, full-time employees, as of today. And it is expected also to increase by another 40 or 50.
At the moment, we have a staff strength of 86. Before the project, we were barely 12. But then when we started operations, we realized that we needed the people.
The most important thing that we ensure is that people do not come into physical contact with the material that we deal with. For this, we provide all the needed safety equipment, which is otherwise called personal protective equipment or PPEs, for people who come into our site.
Ted, currently we are receiving trucks. We are dewatering the sludge. We are dewatering the sewage that we receive. The effluent water is treated further before it is being discharged in the open sea.
At the dewatering section, we add chemical effluent, which mixes with the sludge, the slurry that is coming. Flocks are formed and it's being passed through a dewatering machine. The dewatering machine presses the flocks and the water, the lishi, passes through different sections, whilst the sludge, which is about 40 to 60% moisture, goes through other side. The lishi that comes out, that is semi-clear water, is sent to the UASB, where we generate the biogas. It is an anaerobic process.
Methods adopted in the physiochemical laboratory are of reputable standards accepted worldwide. Laboratory apparatus or instruments used here are all in conformity with international standards. The research section of the department has been tasked to come up with findings that will serve as pointers to the likelihood of the generation of compost from the sludge.
We have also been tasked to see the possibility of getting liquid manure from the leachate. So this is also under study. We are also taking the physicochemical parameters as well as the microbiological characteristics of this parameter, of this leachate, and then the sludge is also being monitored to see whether we can generate some IGF from it.
Biogas is then generated and goes to the desulfurization tower for purification for the electricity generation section.
That room, we have two generators. Each one is supposed to deliver 500 kVA power. The power that will be generated will be used to power the plant.
The standard measurement for the BOD, that is the biochemical oxygen demand, should not go beyond 50 milligrams per liter. And the COD, that is the chemical oxygen demand, should not exceed 250 milligrams per liter.
The other parameters also have their standards that we have to make sure we meet before we discharge into the lagoon or the sea.
The effluent being received currently ranges from 13,000 to 20,000 milligrams per liter for the COD, whilst the BOD is yet to be measured. Now, the total solids measured from the very beginning measures from 6,500 to 21,000 milligrams per liter. The overflow from the UASB tanks goes to the different chambers, the anoxic and aerobic tanks. The water from here moves to the clarifiers or sedimentation unit.
Where we clarify the water, we do separation, we take out any sludge that will be formed from the clear water.
The COD measurement, the effluent is supposed to be around 250 milligrams per liter. And the nature of the analysis is just that the standard methods, whether it's colorimetric, closed flask, stoichiometric, whichever method that you use has a limitation. Some of them has a limitation of about 400 milligrams per liter. When it goes above that, you cannot measure. Depending, that is, you can't use that method. Other methods to go above. But this effluent, because it's the first time in the category, we were theoretically expecting something around 20,000 or maybe above. So some of the standard methods cannot measure. So we decided some of the effluent will use the tachymetric, but with the influent, because of the extent of COD in it, we switch to the conventional methods.
The movement of water continues into the room called the UVR, where ultraviolet rays is passed through it before the final destination in the clear water tank.
But before it goes there, we treat it with a lot of chemicals, as the Ghana water people do. We treat it before it passes through the UV. And when it comes out, it's supposed to be clean. Is that water that will be used to power the plant, run the plant, so that we cut the amount of water that we bring in from the Ghana water. That one will also save us cost. And we also use some of the water for our vegetation maintenance.
Currently, the process in the plant all throughout is the dewatering stage, and the COD, that is the chemical oxygen demand, is taken to about 80 milligrams. The inflow of the COD from the offloading bay measures between 13,000 to 20,000 milligrams. References are made in cross-checking data from the Ghana Standards Authority and the Food and Drugs Board when the need arises for rectifying problems with method application.
The sludge, that is removed. Right now, what we are doing is, we send it to the sludge drying beds where we dry the sludge. What we tend to do is do analysis on it to see or to know whether the sludge that has been dried can be used as fertilizer. Right now, the analysis have not been done on it yet. So the ones that have been dried are still there. We will dry it as we get, as the time goes on, we'll be bagging it. We won't throw it away. And the sludge too, there are plants in the way to convert it to charcoal so that we can use in our various homes.
About a week ago, we were invited by the Honorable Minister of Local Government together with some members of the Parliament to present an update on the project. Due to the importance of the water sanitation in the country.
We have the same plant at Kotoku, also a fecal treatment plant. So the trucks that will come from the northern part of Accra, Chimota, Sawam, all those surrounding areas, instead of driving all the way to the Lavender Hill, they would go to the Kotoku fecal treatment plant. The capacity of that one, the Kotoku fecal treatment plant, is about 1,000 cubic per day. And the Lavender fecal treatment plant is 2,000 cubic per day. So that is supposed to take all the fecal tracts that come into the Accra Central.
In the next 5 years, we're looking at SSGL having similar plants in at least all the metropolitans in Ghana. And we're looking at doing business also with other West African countries.
Government need to get some support, because they are, at the end of the day, the entity that is paying for the management of this facility. We have salaries to pay, we pay for chemicals, we pay for maintenance, for repairs, and all this is an ongoing process. It doesn't end by completing the construction, it's an ongoing process.
For over 60 years, the indiscriminate disposal of waste into the open sea, the overwhelming unpleasant stench that engulfed the entire coastline of Jamestown and Kologono at Lavender Hill has just given way to the newly built treatment and management plant, setting the stage for fresh air and smiles along these shores of the Gulf of Guinea.